Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of EverQuest Old School. And on tonight's episode, I am joined by a number of really good friends. We have ZKP99 with us.
What's going on, YouTube? ZK here. And yes, I am back. I haven't recorded in a while, but I'm here with these guys again today.
It's good to have you back, man.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Yeah, it's good to be back for all of us. We've had a little break there just for about, I don't know, 7 to 10 days or something like that. We haven't really been recording too much. Some issues with sound. Of course, I've been sick as well. And so there's going to be a lot of updates. Things have changed here that we're going to be going over. And we're going to go down each and every single person and let them tell you a little bit about what's been going on with them. But before we do that, we're going to go ahead and continue with the introductions, guys. We also have Hydros Inc.
What's up, everybody? It's Stu the Barbarian! And guys, I'm at the library. If that was a little quiet, I apologize.
So he's not.
I like to bust people's eardrums out.
Barbarian!
We also have Alara with us, or Bushido Bull.
Hey, hey, hey.
And then we have Flip Flop. And Flip Flop is our resident monk tonight. He's pulling for us over in Soul B. We're in the window room at the moment. And he's been doing a fantastic job. We've actually been grouping with him quite a bit lately, and it's always a joy to have him out. We love the guy. He doesn't say too much in chat, unfortunately, most of the time, but other than that, we do love to have him with us. Maybe one day we'll get him in the Skype call. I know he kind of plays while he's at work and things of that sort sometimes, so that's why he's not really able to talk too often. But
I thought it was Philip.
I
thought it was Philip, not Flip.
Well, I thought it was Philip as well until you read his last name. You know, and he's trying to go for that flip-flop, but I think somebody had already taken it. So he threw that H in there. But yeah, it definitely would be kind of like a Philip kind of thing. A Philip flip-flop. I don't know how you would say the last name with the H.
Wow, there's nothing to pull anywhere.
Yeah, he's pretty much pulled everything. I mean, he's been doing really well. But guys, we're going to go down the list. I'm going to let everybody tell you what level they are, because as I said, we have been playing a little bit since the last episode you may have saw. And yeah, there's been some updates. So we're going to start with Hydros Inc.
What's up, guys? You know, I'm level 44. Got it like the last time me and AC played together. And today, the only news I have for you guys is a friend of mine gave me a really good deal on Frostbringer. So I'm going to link that and let everybody check that out. I'm in love with this weapon. I think I paid like... the friend just gave me a really good deal. He really hooked me up. But he made a little money himself, too. So that's a good outcome, dude. So awesome.
That win-win for everybody on that one.
Yeah, dude. That was such a great thing to happen. And when I proc with it, I hold aggro really well. So I'm really happy about getting Frostbringer.
It's amazing. But he's a really good friend, and he's helped us out a ton before. So
thank you, special friend.
Yeah, special friend. We're not telling the name of. If he wants to, we'll definitely throw his name in there. But we don't want to, you know, point fingers at people and be like, oh, that's what's going on. Because some of you guys love to give us gifts, but you don't want anybody to know who you are. But we really don't require gifts, guys. We just like having your company, and you guys already know that by now. We're just gonna be very gracious and say thank you for all the stuff that you guys have done for us, guys.
There's a kobold above that window.
Oh, is there? Okay, let me come back and get him.
Now, you were saying that there's another weapon, though, that you should get, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Infestation.
Yeah, infestation. So.
That's what I suggested to him. And it drops in Dragon Necropolis, but unfortunately, you can't trade it. It's no drop.
Right. Okay. I wonder if I could take my warrior in there one day and just get it when somebody dropped it. Or is it highly sought after? Does it ever rot? It's probably never going to rot, right?
It rots, man. It's part of the Vile Fang quest, but I mean, it rots because he drops like 3 or 4 of them. So I mean,
really,
it's just hard getting in there, right? Like to the actual spot where it drops.
Yeah, because there's a whole bunch of rats. There's dragon constructs that see through invis. I mean, it's just a pain in the butt sometimes.
Yeah, it's like over in Velks. There's a Shadow Knight weapon that drops over there. It's no trade as well. But it's not quite easy to get to, you know, so you can't really run over there with a low level. But we'll definitely head over there, man. We need a key to get in there, though.
Oh, Philip just dinged.
Oh, nice, man. Congrats,
Flip,
dude.
Sorry, not Philip.
Philip,
I'm just going to call him Fred. I'm just going to call him Fred.
But yeah, he's a good guy. We love having him with us. Hopefully, we can get him up a little bit higher in level, because we have, like I said, been playing quite a bit this last week, and we've leveled up a lot. At least I should say most of us have, you know, I'm level 50 right now, guys. I do apologize. Jesus. Like, it's just crazy. Last time you saw me, I was probably like 44 or something like that. I mean, I'm 50 now and about two bubbles into it already, which is just nuts. And Thum has gotten up to 44. As soon as we get him to 45, yes. What do you think about it, man? What do you think about Soulby? Like, it's nuts, right?
I like it, man. It's starting to get a little, like, same old to me. Right. Which is, it's not really fair to the zone, guys. And I'll tell you why, because the experience in here is just phenomenal. And there's so many places. I mean, we've literally been to Windows, Noble, and Royals. And I'm sure there are other great camps in here that I would love to explore. We're just, you know, I don't know. Why haven't we moved into the...
We're just your level, basically.
Yeah, we're just a bit too low right now. Okay, I mean, I'm only level 40 and you're 44, man. If we want to take on the Afridi, we got to be at least level 50.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, you could probably do it if everybody was 44 or 45 to take on the Afridi. I mean, if you really were, you know, on the top of your game.
It's just that he gates and he casts wizard nukes, so he hurts bad if you don't interrupt him.
Yeah.
Now, what would your role as an enchanter be in that fight, ZK?
Load up stuns, man. I got enchanter stuns.
Okay, so you'd be stunning him. All right, yeah. Okay.
We could always go to Bug and Bats, though. I mean, that might be a good place.
There's also Lava Duck Crawlers. That is another good camp. There's a couple names up there. There's Lava Beetles as well. I mean...
Yeah, or Giants. You know, Giants are something we could kill, too, down the road. But, yeah, we just kind of been waiting for your level. Going in a little further can be hard to get your corpses back if you die, so...
To be honest with you, I'm really, really, really excited about going to kill fire giants. That is something that I am...
There's actually three or four different named giants. There's King Tranix, which is on an 8-hour respawn, but yeah. And he drops the crown on King Tranix, which sells for about 15k right now. But yeah, it's because it's a good enchanter piece, and it's got a lot of charisma. So it's got about 20 charisma, so it's nice. Oh.
And a few resist on it too, right? Or am I thinking of the different one? Oh, and I think we're losing them on the Skype call, guys. So we'll try to get them back as soon as possible. Let's see. Skype is... it's doing its thing, guys. I don't know about Skype, man. Sometimes we have issues with it. But as far as me, guys, any updates until we get them back, I'll tell you guys what I've been doing. I have been leveling quite a bit just because I haven't had anything else to be able to do while I've been sick. You know, I've been over in the East Common Tunnels, and the East Common Tunnels, if you've been playing for the last week, you've probably seen me over there selling backpacks. I've been selling backpacks like crazy. You buy the pelts for about 30 platinum a piece, and the bear pelts, and then you sell the backpack for about 60 platinum. And, you know, you're doubling your money, but you don't always do it very quickly. So you may sit there for, you know, 4, 5, 6 hours buying nothing but pelts and spending 100 of platinum, you know, just getting pelt after pelt after pelt, and then all of a sudden have a rush on backpacks, and you go through every single one of your pelts. So if you start to add up with them, it can start to look kind of bleak. You're like, you're spending hundreds of plat, and you're not making any money off of it, but... I've never gotten to the point, if I stay long enough, that I've ever had to leave with any pelts. That's people always need backpacks. And they're pretty good backpacks, to be honest. So I definitely like them. These are the ones that I have right here. These are the weight reduction. The main thing is the size. You have 10 capacity. And those crates that you can buy over in Great Divide is... Are we zoning it? Oh, he's zoned. Okay, yeah, he just did it by accident. I'm just making sure we're not in over our head here. The Thum was out looking for a pool, apparently. But yeah, if you see me over in the commons, I know a lot of you have sent me messages letting me know things and just saying that you love the videos and that this is a good time for us to actually talk, because it was, you know, it was like I wasn't doing videos over there. So it was a really nice, you know, moment to be able to sit down and actually, you know, touch base with a lot of you guys and just kind of just relax and become part of the community for once. I mean, a lot of the time when we do these videos, I don't have a chance to talk in guild. I don't have a chance to talk in group. I don't know. We're going to go ahead and cancel Skype on the call, I guess. Maybe it's being lame. I keep getting sucked into other discussions. What have I done? Let's see. It's not letting me in the call. That's fantastic. So what we're going to go ahead and do, guys, is going to pause this video, and we'll restart it here in a second. Hey guys, welcome back. We do apologize for the technical difficulty, but we did lose Skype, it decided to, in the middle of the video, that, hey, there's an update. I don't care if you're on a call. Go ahead and restart and interrupt you, which is, you know, Skype. It's amazing.
Skype, yay, love it.
But we're back now, and we're going to keep going with the video. We do apologize for these weird little issues, but they do happen from time to time. Now, you guys remember what we were talking about? Because I know I went into, like, this whole spiel of what I've been doing the last week, which is hanging out in the East Common Tunnels. Selling backpacks, and I've actually made a ton of freaking money doing that. I have about $3,000 in the bank from just selling
that one,
backpacks.
That one's messed. Pull it back, Doom.
Okay. I was talking about making love to chickens.
Oh my god. Seriously, chickens?
I'm just kidding. I just really like chickens, guys.
That's really. You know, the way a man loves a chicken, I guess.
Yeah, bow, chicka, bow, wow, you know what I'm saying?
No, I do not. I can definitely say I have no clue.
Yeah,
I
vegetarians can never understand, dude.
I definitely have some news, though.
Oh, yeah,
what's your news,
it,
brother?
There's gonna a couple of my guildies and I, you know, now that I just got my internet back, we decided to play the new GAC beta that's coming out, and it is already out, and we're liking that. We're playing that. I'm playing a seer so far. I'm level 20, and having a blast. It's I'll send you guys the link later. You know,
wait, what's the game called?
It's called it's an Outguard beta, but it's a DAOC, like classic DAOC server. And I got a hold of them, and they will allow me to record YouTube videos, so I'm going to be uploading that.
Blizzard, dude, you need to hook me up on how to get up.
It's not Blizzard. It's the guys from Dark Age of Camelot that made a private server, or not a private server, but like P99 of their version, but yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so it's Dark Age of Camelot.
Yeah,
never
classic,
seen
though.
Nobody likes Dark Age of Camelot.
What are you talking about? Dark Age of Camelot is a fantastic game. I used to play that quite a bit myself.
They made a Dark Age Camelot, you know, classic server. So I mean, we're playing that and we're having a blast.
Oh, heck yeah,
I actually
man.
Never played it. I would like to play Dark Age of Camelot.
Oh, it's
so
an amazing game. Very, very close to EverQuest in a lot of respects, but different enough that makes it interesting.
I'll definitely send you guys the link afterward after we get done recording.
Oh, yeah.
And I'll post.
Do you
it.
Have to have software?
What?
Well, you gotta have the game, I'm sure.
Yeah.
You can download the game from the website, man.
Oh, it's completely
free.
There
you go.
Yeah.
Oh, nice, man. That's fantastic. I'll definitely put that on a link on this video, guys, down below in the section. If I forget about that, ride me until I you know, put that down there for you guys, because that is a fantastic game to play. If you have not tried Dark Ages of Camelot, definitely go give it a shot, guys. I think
I mean, it's exactly like it was when it first came out. You know, there's, you know, that's what they're trying to do. They're trying to make a Dark Age of Camelot classic server, and that's what they did.
Exactly as it was when it first came out, so not as good as EverQuest.
Oh, come on, dude. Come on, dude.
He's never even played it, so, you know.
I'm just playing it.
I had a lot of fun playing Dark Age of Camelot.
So did I. I'll definitely go there with you.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of good things about Dark Age of Camelot.
Yeah, man, I got a hold of them, and I can definitely record YouTube videos, so I'm looking forward to that, and, you know. But my guildies are so much higher than I am. They're like level 50 and 40.
Wow, already?
How long
has it been out?
The beta's only been out a week, man.
Oh my god, hardcore players to the extreme, guys. That is nuts. That's crazy. But is there a lot of people on the server so far? What are the numbers that you normally see?
It's a couple hundred right now, but I mean it's growing as it's only been out a week.
Yeah.
So I mean,
you get passing the word around, definitely, man, definitely, yeah.
A couple hundred after a week is not bad for a progression server that a lot of people probably don't know that too much about at the moment. So. I'm looking forward to seeing that grow. I would definitely like to spend some time over there on that classic server and try it out. Probably not going to take me. It's probably not going to take me away from EverQuest because you know I just love EverQuest. But it definitely will be something I can try from time
to
time.
Yeah,
same here. I got them both missed.
I've got some other news too, guys, that I forgot all about. I just found out I've been looking on Newegg, and I've been looking on. I've been looking on Newegg, but Tiger Direct.
He's checked, by the way.
So the computer that I want to buy to start playing new games and making better looking videos is only $1,100 now. I mean, some of them were even $800 with the same stats, same gear, and everything and stuff like that. So I'm really probably going to only save up $2,000, which. But the thing is it's Windows 10, and I actually was telling me that he could help me figure out how to run P99 on Windows 10, but I think I'm just going to keep doing the Project 1999 videos on this computer, even though they're only 360p, and do all the other games on the new computer. But yeah, really the only game that I foresee playing in the near future besides EverQuest would be DayZ. So, but that's the main reason I'm buying the new computer, is so that I have a computer capable of playing DayZ, because this computer that I own currently will not.
You know, I actually have an extra copy of Windows 7 that you're more than welcome to, and that would solve all your problems, because Windows 10 blows so badly, guys. I cannot even stress how much I hate Windows 10. But Windows 7 will be more than enough for you. It's still being updated, I think, until they said 2020 or something like that, so you'll still get updates for it and all that other stuff. But yeah, for older games like this, definitely going with an older operating system will probably help you.
Then I'll probably take you up on that, friend, because I loved Windows 7. Windows 7 was my favorite behind Windows. It was Windows 95, Windows 98, and Windows 7 for me, guys. Those are my three favorite Windows of all time. So Windows 8.1 is not bad either. I've had no difficulty at all with playing Project 1999 with 8.1. So
yeah, I'm not a big fan of the direction Windows went in. But to be honest, they're not making nearly as much money as they need to make to be able to make a profit. So I really don't see Windows being around very much longer. I think it's probably going to go to a Linux-based system, because that's where a lot of the cell phones are going to.
I'm back. Sorry about that.
Oh, welcome back, man. No, you're right.
So I wish I knew more about it to understand. You know, I kind of don't understand what the difference is between. I know there are two different operating systems. Yeah, but I wonder why Linux is currently beating Windows.
It's not that it's beating Windows. It's just that it's free, so that anybody can download it, anybody can modify it. It's modified it by the community, and you look at like Google's new operating system on their cell phones and tablets and things of that sort is based off of Linux as well, because it's free, so they can take that, they can modify it, and then they can ship it out there for people to use. So it's just a base that is really good. It works. It's been around for a long time. A lot of people know how to use it. It's just not as user-friendly. It's not prepackaged. It's not, I don't want to say dumbed down, but that's kind of what you try to do when you create an operating system that's just going to go out to anybody and everybody. You want to make sure that anybody and everybody can use it. At least, I used to know my way around here. Be right back. Okay, so she doesn't know her way here, apparently. She's coming over here to get some gold for me, guys. That's why I'm getting those messages. But yeah, it's a pretty cool operating system. I like it. It's just a learning curve of learning a whole other operating system. Sucks, you know? Like, you're used to Windows, you know where everything is in Windows. Or you're used to Mac, you know where everything is in a Mac. You really don't want to switch over to a new operating system and have to learn all that stuff all over again. What do you guys use? You all use Windows, or is anybody using a Mac right now?
I use Windows.
Yeah, I use Windows too, man. I've never used anything other. I know exactly what you're talking about, though. I've never used anything besides Windows.
Yeah, so, but other than that, guys, this game seems to run fine on both of them. I've heard people who play Macs are able to play this game just fine, and people who run even Windows 10 can still sit there and figure out the quirks of getting it to work. It just...
the thing is with Windows 10, I have a Windows 10, and I play in... There's an option on there to, you know, for a compatibility mode that you can... For programs and different things that you can... play different games in Windows mode or Windows 7 mode, and you can play it in Windows 2000 mode, etc., for different games and stuff, you know, if you need to. But yeah, just so, I mean, if you have Windows 10 and you're trying to install P99, always go to the compatibility mode setting and then install it in the Windows 7. It works easier, in my opinion.
So okay. it works just, that's really all you gotta do is go to the compatibility and put it in 7. Well, see, then I'm not too worried about... Well, the thing is, though, guys, is this computer that I'm using right now, it plays P99 fine. And, yeah, it doesn't give me the best quality. I mean, 360p is not the best, but, you know, I'm not really worried about the graphics and stuff like this.
You got to remember, this game came out in 99. They didn't have too many fancy features.
Right, yeah.
They didn't have very high-tech computers back then either. So.
Yeah, you also got to think about it this way, man. Once you get a new computer, you're not going to want to play the old one again. Like, you're going to want to use the new one.
Yeah, for sure.
What happened?
Are you kidding me? I zoned again. I guess to Soleil. I guess there's like seven entrances to Soleil on the side or something.
There's a couple of them. Yeah, one of each ramp for sure.
See, I don't know this song very well, guys. So that's the second time actually that I've done that. Apparently, at two different. Yeah, so I'm just learning. I'm just little.
Yeah, I'm just a baby.
Yeah, but no, like I was saying, what I was saying about that Dark Age Camelot server is that, you know, that there it's like it was back in the day, and it's basically the P99, and it's either pronounced Youthguard or Youthguard or something like, I don't know how to pronounce it at all, but it's gonna be fun with how popular it is already.
You notice?
So now, did you play it back in the day, ZK?
Yeah, I played it back in the day when it came out in 2001.
Okay, so which do you think is better, man? EverQuest or Dark Age of Camelot?
Oh, I like that.
Let me put you on the spot, brother.
Come on.
You don't have to answer that if you don't want to.
That's like going through that whole debate of like EverQuest versus WoW. I think they're two very different games.
I like
my opinion. I believe that EverQuest.
I'll answer that question. I like EverQuest and Dark Age Camelot, both equally the same. That's my opinion.
It may sound like a cop out, but it's actually pretty. No, they're actually really good games. I mean, I played WoW for a long time, and I played Dark Ages of Camelot for a long time, and I think they're
Royals,
both.
Royals is open. He says we can move in there after this.
Oh yeah, for sure, man.
What you guys want to do, man?
There's only.
I was thinking go to Sabella's, man. We're actually planning on going to Sabella's, guys, next few times.
Well, we got to get the keys for it first.
I'm too low. Yeah, we should go to the City of Mist. I'm too low level to go to Sabella's at level 40.
I think I am, too. I don't think I'd do a very good job. Well, maybe the entrance. I might do okay there, but...
Yeah, you couldn't get past it. Everything else is too high level and hits too hard, man.
Oh, yeah. So, Sabella's, I love that zone, though. I can't wait till we can get down on the bottom level and just... getting growl, dude. We're gonna make so much flat.
The next zone we should go to is City of Mist for sure. I think we should go
Sunday. Let's go this Sunday and maybe even Saturday, guys. We could go today too, man. I'm gonna be here for another 6 hours, man. Yeah.
If you want to go today, man, we can go get a port and run over there and try it out. I mean, it does get contested quite a bit. There's a lot of people in that zone, which is a great thing. You want to zone at least one of them at your level. That you can usually find a group that, even at off hours during the night, is still going strong, and that definitely is one of those zones. So, I mean, that's a good thing. But for us, going in there as a group, I don't know if we're going to be able to find a spot that we can just kind of take over and boom, like, boom, we're here, it's ours.
I'm hoping we do entrance. Yeah, I'm hoping that we can just do entrance. But knowing City of Mist, people are probably camping the entrance, too. So
I mean, we can do a Who Else.
The thing is, we can...
I don't know. We can also do
Emerald Jungle.
I don't know. Yeah, Emerald Jungle is good experience too. But Super Bits of Bob was like level 42 or something, 52 something, and there were still blues in there.
You know,
we can go there. If we can't find a place in City of Mist, we can just go back out into the jungle and have fun.
Yeah, there's only 13 people in City of Mist at the moment, so we could definitely do that.
It's a win-win situation. Bye.
What I was leveling up there on ZK, the temple was always open, man, and there was like 20 people in the zone. People don't go to the temple.
Let's move into Royals if you guys want.
Yeah, let's.
Oh, yeah, let's do it, dude. Flip is probably going to have to pull, dude. I'm going to make a mess.
Let's go ahead and kill my pet first, though, so it doesn't cause a train.
Oh, okay, yeah. I'll come back.
Oh, yeah, that's not a bad idea. Let's go ahead and, you know. What's wrong, AC? You're moving really slow, dude. You in walk mode?
I'm not moving really slow. I don't know what you're talking about, man. I am
get up and walk around.
I am super fast, man. I have no idea what you're talking about. I'm speed lightning.
Are you encumbered again?
I'm faster than Sirkin, guys. So there's no problem.
No, dude. Now you're just spitting water, dude.
Whatever you want to break him, dude.
Hold on, I'm trying to. I'm just gonna invis.
Or hide. You can hide too.
I'd keep failing. I'm just gonna.
Oh, it doesn't. Oh, yeah.
Oh, he doesn't have Targan yet. Yeah, we could definitely get that guy. Do apologize for
probably need to get over there. Okay, come on, guy.
I also wouldn't mind charming Targan after he gets his part of the epic.
Oh my god, we did that.
A
week ago.
Yeah.
And we put all bronze gear on him.
Yeah.
Dude, he's massive. He's some good DPS, man. For a monk, you don't want to put bronze. On a monk, man.
You can't. You can't normally, but you can do it on him, and he kicks the crap out of things so much.
He's tanking, dude. He's doing a better job tanking than me.
Because once you charm something, you can give it anything, man.
He was flying kicking a full set of bronze, dude.
Yeah, he was.
he was not messing around, dude.
And the Enchanter had a couple of really good weapons to give him, something with life siphoning and some other stuff, so his life never went down. It was a beast.
Ooh, I got a patron, man.
You got a what?
Hey, there's that monk again.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
He's looking for group. I don't know the way the royals
All right, guys, champions room.
Boom, baby. We got ourselves royals.
And there will never be royals.
I knew it was coming.
now there are some good items that dropped here. There's the rune mithril bracer. There's the...
breastplate.
The breastplate. There's also the targ and the rock guy for the monk epic. So there's a few other items that drop here as well. So...
Yeah, there's a pair of shoulders that drop here. I think Thum is actually wearing those shoulders right now. They're pretty good.
Yeah, let me link them. They drop. If you kill the priest, they're going to drop, guys. Almost all the time. Almost 90% of the time, they
clarity
drop.
Clarity check.
I like them. Clarity, yeah.
I could definitely use...
Oh, that's actually nice for you, AC, because of the mana.
Yeah, normally that would be what I'd be wearing. In fact, I was wearing it before I went to the Plane of Sky. And I don't know if you guys are going to see this video before you see the Plane of Sky stuff, so I hate to do little spoilers, but I have the Weight of the Gods at the moment, which is just an amazing shoulder slot to have. And just, there's no competition between those two items, so I went ahead and replaced those. But yeah, the 15 mana is really nice, and the AC is definitely something nice to have as well, so... Those will drop, and then there's a warrior weapon that drops here too, right, Thum?
It's called Painbringer, and it's a 7 2.4 second delay or 24, and it has a proc on it. That's a area effect direct damage spell. It's not very high aggro though.
I was actually here with Flats, man, helping him farm Targan.
Oh, nice, man. I haven't seen any videos from Flats in a while. How's he doing, man?
He's doing all right, man.
Yeah, he's a good guy. In fact, Flats, man, if you watch these videos, I'm a huge fan of yours. I used to watch your monk come in there and do stuff. It was just, I love the intro on those things.
So, I've seen, Flats. I've actually subscribed to him. I haven't seen anything from him lately, though. Is he taking a hiatus? Is he came? Do you know?
What's that? Sorry, I was talking to my nephew. Sorry about that.
No.
Okay. Yeah, when's the last time he posted a video, man?
I don't know, man. I haven't been on the channel.
I'm subbed to him. Yeah, I haven't. I'm subbed to him. I haven't seen one. Seems like a couple weeks, dude.
At least he's playing there.
Yeah. I talked to him in game when I was in Planet Growth, man. And he's doing all right. He just I don't think he has time to record right now.
Yeah.
Well, you should extend the invitation, dude. If he ever wants to hang out with us and group with us, dude, he's always welcome, you know?
Yeah, he was talking about it, man, but last time I did the videos with him, I didn't have what he had installed, man. He wanted to do something called Discord. I don't even know what that is, but it sounds fun, and him and
Discord?
Bastard...
Discord.
Discord.
It's like Skype. It's like Skype. It's another one of those.
Oh, yeah. We've actually used it, dude. It's actually an excellent program. I don't know why we don't use it consistently, because Skype. But AC's just a big fan of Skype, man. That's all I got to say about that.
Well, no, I mean, the one thing
about... I don't blame him, dude.
The one thing about Discord that I didn't really care for, there's a lot of good things about it. Like, one, you can raise or lower the volume up for each individual person, whereas on Skype, you can't do that. It's just set, so everybody has to do it on their side.
But hijacks.
The downside to Discord that I didn't really care for was the volume, or not the volume, but the sound quality wasn't as good as Skype was. And I'm pretty picky. I like to give you guys the best I can possibly give you in the quality of the video as well as the sound, which is why I went through all the expense of getting a good mic and all that other nonsense that I went through, which is really not nonsense. It just helps out. But, Skype still has the best quality on sound. And the rooms that we were using on Discord, I don't know if there's a way to change that, but the rooms we were using on Discord were completely open. And so anybody could join whenever they felt like. And that's exactly what happened occasionally. People would jump into the rooms and we'd be recording and talking, and they just kind of jump in and say something weird and then jump out. And I'm like, well, that kind of just ruins the video right there, you know?
Well, he's got his own servers on Discord, okay. so Yeah, so that's he was talking.
What the?
Did you fall in the lava?
I hate my friggin' mouse, dude.
Did you fall in the lava?
Oh my god, yeah, dude. Sometimes.
Get up to the ledge. I'll heal you. There is a way out of that lava. I don't know where it is, but there definitely is a way out. Okay, I'm healing you now. There you go. You're good. Just swim around, and if you need to, just come back to the ledge. I'll keep healing you. I'm at full power of my mana, so you got, you know, all day right there. You got the hit points. You're fine. Just don't panic, right? Isn't that how the little booklet goes? Don't panic.
Yeah. Like I was telling you guys, you know, he wanted to do the videos, and he wanted, you know, to be on the videos, and, you know, actually, and I didn't know what Discord was, and so I'm gonna install it, and, you know, next time he wants me to be in the video, I'll go ahead and get in that and do that. So yeah, just thought I would update you guys on that.
That's great, man. That'd be fantastic to see you on his videos, because like I said, I've been watching his for a long time now. So
me too, man.
Wow. Okay. So
I got that on my phone.
Any luck on?
I thought I had it turned off.
Oh, there you are. You're over there. On the rock.
I'm stuck in the wall.
Yeah, you're on the rock right there. Oh, nope, you're not. Did you rewind it?
Oh. I did rewind it.
Okay. I think you can swim up the lava. The little, the waterfall of lava, or whatever you want to call it, the lava wall.
Yeah, there was a tunnel underneath, but I don't know.
Give Thuma fire resist buff,
okay,
AC.
Let me toss another heal on him real quick and see if I can find the fire resist buff. I don't think I've ever even used that one. There it is, resist fire.
Skype is doing that on us again. Okay, yeah, I think Alar said I could swim up this. Let's try it, guys. Let's try it. Let's see what's going on.
All right, there you go. You're fire resistant, and you got a little regen on you. Hopefully that should be enough. Are you swimming up the lava right now?
No. No, that's not going to happen.
No, you can't swim it up?
I don't know how to get out, guys. No, that's not happening.
Swim down. Mm-hmm. Swim down, man. There may be a way. There may be a tunnel underneath.
There was a tunnel, but it didn't lead anywhere. So, and now I'm stuck again.
All right. He's saying this is oddly satisfying. Let me do another heal on you. Wait. What if you come over here to where we're at? I see a small ledge that maybe you can walk on. You see, to my left, there's the room in the center, right? It seems like there's a small ledge right there. Is there any way you can get to it?
I've tried to get up on that, man, and I keep getting stuck over there.
You can't jump?
Yeah.
You're right there, so you're on it. Is there any way you can strafe the wall and get up a little bit higher? I don't know if there is.
Okay, no, come over here, Tim. Come over here on my side, man, a little bit. Try to go in first person and go in first person and look up and try to get on that ledge.
On this ledge up here?
Oh, yeah, that's not going to happen.
Yeah, that's way too high.
Yeah, you just got to die. You just got to die, man, and we're going to have to drag you.
Well, no, I mean, you keep looking around. There's no room pop.
Yeah, I'm going to keep looking around. Yeah. As long as AC can keep me healed, dude, then
I can find a way out. We're literally right here. We could just target your corpse and drag it up, man.
Yeah, but I'd like to know if there's a way out of there just in case. I mean, we got a room pop in the center if you guys want to pull that.
That's going to suck. Okay, there is a hole right here, guys. Truly, I'm going to go. Throw me a celestial healing, AC.
All right.
I'm going to explore further into that hole right there. Yeah, find out if there is a way.
Okay. Gotcha. Remember, come back if you get down to about 40%. I'll toss you another.
Alright.
Yeah, the fire resist buff should help him out a lot. There's another problem.
Oh, it goes down. It goes down, guys. Yeah,
alright. We're at the Royals, Alar.
Royals, alright. I'm just around the corner.
Alright. Oh, yeah, now that we got Alar back, we should be fine over here with the repops.
Here comes the shaman.
He's casting.
I missed the shaman, so the cast didn't
last. Oh, this is dangerous. If I die down here, dude, then who's gonna rescue me?
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. If you get 40%, just come
back. Oh, I did it!
Don't attack it! Don't attack it, Alar!
You got out?
Yay!
You got out?
I did.
Nice, man. Where did it take you?
Oh no! What the crap? It just took me to this ledge, dude.
There's no, hidden wall or something you go through?
No, dude. What the crap, dude?
I don't know. I wish I could tell you, man, but I've never I've never fallen down there with my shadow.
Let me cast Blindsight on you and see what you're working with. See if I can help you.
Almost all my breath's gone.
Let's see if my life can last while I make it back here.
Hold on, Doom. Hold on.
Let me know when you get close enough.
Kill that pet, Alara. Kill that pet.
I'm gonna have to make it back to you for you to cast anything on me.
No, I said kill it now. Kill it. Everything's on.
You're on your way back, Doom?
Yep. All right. Trying to make it back, dude.
I'm trying to get you.
I'm getting beat up. I need a heal.
Oh crap, man.
Go, I got it.
Healing coming, man.
Oh man, I'm in a bad spot, dude. I don't know how to get back.
You don't know how to get back?
Oh, this is not good.
This is not good, man.
No, I think I got turned around, dude. I'm gonna die.
Knocking futs, man. You gotta get close so we can drag your corpse.
Ah, crap, dude. I'm stuck. This is bad.
Are you gonna die?
Hold on. Yep. I'm trying to cast Blindsight on you.
Oh, here we go. Stay wherever you're at. I'm healing you now. There we go.
Oh, nice, dude.
All right,
dude, hit the X button so you can crouch, man. Try to crouch.
All right. There we go.
See if you can swim. Yeah, see, there you go. You're swimming now.
Yeah, I'm back.
There
you are. There's a tunnel out, dude, but there's no way to get out of the tunnel, so I guess I'm just going to have to die, dude.
Yeah, there is, but you just might not survive getting there.
Yeah, I'd rather die and you guys pull me out.
Dude, right. I got Blindsight on you, man. I'm seeing the world through your eyes, Zoom.
The fiery inferno.
Yeah, he's dying under the lava right now.
All right, just swing up over closest to this wall so we don't have to worry about you not being close enough, and we'll drag you. Make sure you're right on top of that wall, though.
Oh, yeah, somebody target me. Mm-hmm.
I got you targeted.
Okay, alright. Yeah, just let me die, man.
That sucks, man. Apologize. Wish we could do
it's
something.
It's Thum's fault.
It's not your fault, dude.
It's always Thum's fault.
My mouse, my right click, it sticks sometimes.
Yeah.
And you've heard me complain about it many times, but
I have.
And sometimes it'll make me. It'll propel me forward and it won't let me stop, and that's exactly what happened. I was screaming in horror as it happened.
You need a consent, Doom.
Alright.
Bad time to fall in the lava, Doom.
Yeah, I know. Room break, dude. My bad, guys. I totally didn't mean to do that.
I got two guys on me.
What kind of shaman, or what kind of warrior are you, man?
I'm more like a shaman, dude. Die really quick when I catch aggro.
That's not a shaman, man.
Assist
the monk. Assist the monk. Don't worry.
Take your time. Make sure you're able to break that room and keep it broken. And don't worry about resume until a while.
It's always assist the tank, Alara, since Thum's not here.
Yeah, but Demiro yelled for help, so I went over.
Well, no, yeah, I was letting ZK know so he could mess him.
Yeah. I still need consent to him.
I consented, you did.
It says I don't have permission.
Did you spell it right? Try it again.
Same here.
Try that.
There we go.
You try that?
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, I think I have to capitalize your name, guys. I think I haven't been capitalizing names.
Do you capitalize mine?
Usually when I give somebody consent, I just type out their name, but it seems to be working now only when I capitalize the first letter in the name. So, like, I spelled out Veldeth's name regularly when I first did it, and then when he asked me to reconsent him, I gave him I just capitalized his first name, and then I gave him consent immediately. I don't know.
That's kind of weird. I mean, I know you've had... She was trying to get here to get that gold, and she was not able to figure out where we were, so she had to gate back out, unfortunately. But
you may have to go down.
No, she's just gonna run to the bank and grab it.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. How much experience did you lose? Oh, we got a repop.
So did you owe her money?
No, I didn't owe her anything.
Why you owe
her?
She just wanted to borrow money. Okay.
Yeah, because she was over here at Soul, whatever you call that, Temple of Soul.
Soul B? Oh, the Temple of Soul Sky?
Temple of Soul Sky, yeah. Mm-hmm. So now, what's your favorite part of this zone, AC?
Now, hold on a second.
What do you mean? What's going on?
I was just gonna tell you, but no, my favorite part of this zone. That's a tough one because I appreciate pretty much this entire place because I spent so much time here in Classic. It's kind of like Lower Guck, trying to pick that one room that you enjoy the most when the zone itself is just insanely fun. Because as you said, we've been over here in Royals, which is amazing experience. And for those of you who are trying to like picture how much experience we get in Royals compared to Avelius, which is absolute garbage when it comes to experience. Great on loot, but absolute garbage on experience.
You're speaking the truth, man.
Yeah, it is horrible. I went to the hole, and I spent about 4 hours there, and I got, I would say, about 8% experience. Over here, I get about 8% experience in about 10 seconds. Like, it's nuts. I'm not even, like, exaggerating on that. In 10 seconds...
Is it Nuck and Futz?
It's Nuck and Futz, guys. What? It's Nuck and Futz.
But, I actually like the hole as his own, dude. I like it. I don't probably. I mean, I like it as a zone. I do. I have fun every time I go there.
No, there's nothing wrong with it, and it drops some pretty good loot as far as like experience goes. That's not where you want to go.
The hole is in a Avelius zone now.
Still, I'm just saying like that's a pretty bad zone for experience. I also went to Velk's, and Velk's was absolutely horrible for experience as well.
As I was telling you guys, like I said, it's not. Uh-oh. You know,
like dead.
Yeah, Monk just...
I want to go to Vogue's Library. What kind of mobs are in Vogue's Laboratory, guys?
Spiders? Oh, man.
You're... Spiders and frozen golems.
Spiders, kobolds.
Giants, too, right?
No. I didn't see any giants in there.
Only Velkator is the giant in there.
Yeah, he's a giant scientist.
You're going to love pulling in that zone, by the way, though, man, because there's a lot of... you know, it's ramps, and then when you get to the very top of the ramp where the platform should be, there's a giant hole, and so you'll fall down through it and get trained and stuff like that.
I'll be pulling on my monk in there, man, for you guys. No worries.
They got to add, guys.
And there's a lot of floors that occasionally will be slippery when you walk upon them. So you really need to memorize every little path and where you can run and where you can't run because you can fall down so easy in that zone, and it's just certain death if you do. But the loot is amazing. Those.
I can't get this one. This one's yellow to me.
I'll root him here in a second. Okay.
I got him. I'll get him off of you.
He's rooted.
There we go.
But those,
all right, switching back to the other one.
Those hand wraps that you have, those drop over there. That drop off of the frenzy group. You have the upper.
Ones that I used to have?
Well, you're going to get them back, I'm hoping.
I was telling you guys that Velius isn't very good experience, but it's mainly just for the cash camp, man.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely on that one. Let me go ahead and root this guy so you can back it up.
It's just new experiences, man. I mean, it's things that we haven't done. We've all been to... It seems like we've been to most of the zones, like over in Norrath for sure. We've been to a few of the zones over in, over in Kunark. You know, Velius is something we've barely tapped, I've barely tapped. So,
no, that's why I wanted to check them out, is because it was something new.
A lot of the zones are harder than you can't just go in there and kill stuff. I mean, you're gonna die, and it's hard. It really is. I mean, it's no joke. I mean, Sarn's Grotto is the hardest dungeon that there is for groups, man. I mean, things AoE and dispel at the same time, so it's hard, man.
Nasty. Nasty, man.
You know, Velk's was really not that bad, though. Like, at the entrance, the spiders, yeah, they poison and stuff like that, but they're pretty easy.
Well,
you know?
Some of them backstab, man.
Yeah, they definitely do that.
Because I have no buffs.
Yeah, I have no power, so...
Oh, okay, no buffs, and I still have res effect, too, so...
Let's hold pulse after this.
Got it. No problem.
Yeah, we'll end the episode there, guys, but I'm just trying to compare the zones together, you know, because Soul B is amazing for experience. This is where you come to if you're trying to level up.
So Soul A is good, back. Too.
Yeah, and it's great on loot, too, because you get...
Yeah, we had a lot of fun in Soul A. Yeah, a lot of fun in Soul A. Soul A was a good zone.
But you can get some pretty good loot in here, too, once you get a little further into the zone. As we said, Royals definitely has some good loot for you available.
The Afridi boots, dude.
The Afridi boots, sure. Definitely, yeah.
What cloak are you using, Doom?
Let me see. Sorry, guys. My mouth is full of nuts, so.
Yeah.
Spider fur cloak?
Link it.
Yeah, there's a dexterity robe that drops here that's really nice as well, so I think we might be able to get him that one.
Well, so what were you laughing at, AC? Were you laughing at the fact that my mouth is full of nuts? Is that what you were laughing at? That's wrong, dude. Why you gotta judge me, dude?
I was gonna say the one zone we haven't been to yet as a group, and I'm surprised by that, is we haven't been to Mistmore yet.
Oh, I want to go to that. Yeah, I want to go to the castle, dude. I do.
Yeah.
Well, there, the courtyard man is good experience and good money. There's the hooded black cloak that drops there that would be good for Thum as well.
We're a little outside the range, though.
Let us go, dude.
No, I mean,
no,
on these guys.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, the problem we had with that one is that we always kind of go as a group, and Mistmore is one of those zones, like we were saying with City of Mist, that it's pretty much always camp, so...
Well, what I was saying was, man, Courtyard is never camp because it's the higher-level mobs, and people... The groups don't go there because they can't handle it, or they're too scared. So,
if you
want
to go back to Mistmore, man, I would love that, dude. Weren't we planning on going somewhere Sunday or Saturday?
City of Mist, I think.
Yeah, City of Mist.
Or today. We might go to City of Mist today.
I'll be down
for
that.
Yeah, we could do it after this video.
What's the deal with the boat room? How do you unlock it if you don't have a rogue with you?
There
was a key that was dropped by a particular mob over in the stables. But he never drops it on B99.
Yeah, he does. There's a way. There's always a way in, man. You can levitate around stuff and, you know, left trick around stuff, so...
But guys, I think this is a pretty good spot to go ahead and have Thum make love to a chicken off camera, guys, and...
Subscribe!
Is that what we're calling it?
Oh, my God. Till next time, guys.
Is that what the kids are calling it these days?
I think so. Yeah. I mean, you know, chicken love, guys. Chicken love.
Get your book on.
But we'll catch you all, guys, next time.
Subscribe.
Hey guys, and welcome to the disembodied voice of AC Gamer. We are definitely going to be doing a lot more series in the future, but here are a few of them that you guys might find interesting. Of course, you're more than welcome to check them out. I would love to hear your comments. Again, if you do enjoy these videos, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe. It's definitely the indicator that I use to tell if you guys want to see more videos like that, of that particular game style, of that series in the long run. So when you guys leave comments down, it helps me decide whether we should keep doing it, as well as whether you want to see games like that in the future. And here are a few of them right here. I kind of picked out a few of different genres. We will be doing spotlights for other YouTubers in the future. So if you want to get a little shout out, definitely let me know. If you group with me, chances are you will get a shout out in here eventually. But for now, these are just four series that I have that I feel like could use a little bit more attention, and that you guys might actually enjoy as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and we will definitely catch you all next time.